Today we'll be making some iodine from povidone iodine. I have obtained some 7.5 milliliters of povidone iodine. Now I'm going to mix some of the sodium hydroxide inside povidone iodine using some by adding just directly or by adding some solution of sodium hydroxide. It will convert them into sodium iodine and sodium iodide and iodate. It will be mixture of iodine and iodine mixture. Some of the sodium hydroxide got stuck inside the funnel, so I will put some of the solution inside the povidone iodine and we'll see the result. As we can see that it doesn't change any color, but because I have added much low of sodium hydroxide, so I will add the chunks, more of the chunks of sodium hydroxide crystals inside the solution to make it more, make it iodide of sodium sodium and iodate of sodium ions. It will change to very yellow color of color as does it will reduced into sodium iodide and povidone complex, povidone polymer. Just if you can see this sludge, don't worry, we will deal with it afterwards. Now lots of stirring with the and filter it through cotton. You can also use gravity filtration or a vacuum filtration, but I'm going to be using a cotton filtration here. We have the filtration. Now keep inside the heating venter and heat it for an hour or so to get its volume reduced to 75 mils. Now here's the solution of sodium iodide after heating. Now filter it through it to separate povidone complex polymer from the solution. The viscous you see is polymer povidone and other boiling juice iodide to stop bumping it produces. The povidone iodine has a texture of chalk, which is very viscous and hard to separate with hand. Now add a solution, equal volume of hydrochloric acid and water inside the sodium iodide solution. This will change back into the red color, which forms hydrogen iodide and sodium chloride as side products. Stir it very properly so as to mix everything which we had. Now I add 30% hydrogen peroxide or 3% hydrogen peroxide. I am going to dilute 30% hydrogen peroxide to 3 to 4% hydrogen peroxide by adding equal amounts of 100 milliliters of water to 25 milliliters of hydrogen peroxide. You can still use 30% or 3%, depend upon you how much you can use. We lost our stirring. Now add it very slowly. You can see that it changed to black color, which means that the hydrogen iodide has break down into hydrogen or some or water or and iodine. Now if I will going to add in color, it spilled some off, but it's not a so much big deal. I'm going to add more of the hydrogen peroxide to convert it back some of the hydrogen iodide to some iodine. I'm going to just add 25% of hydrogen peroxide with 10 ml of just water. Here we are after settling it down, decant it or filter it off. I'm going to decant the water present upwards and I will add all the water to it and I will throw that solution. It is not for use. Now filter it through the coffee filter. Or anything you can use, filter it very carefully. And clean the glass to anything with water. Here we after the dry and let's sit for one day. Next day we are here. Now keep inside the beaker and keep inside the beaker. And you can also directly put in or can you can put contents directly inside it, but I'm going to do that directly inside it, but because it lost it is little some of my iodine. Now keep inside the heating metal or heating plate, whatever you have, and keep some ice to condense the hard iodine vapors. It will sublimate at 113.5 degree Celsius. It will not melt, nor it will nor it will liquefy at 113 degree. You can see the distinct purple color of iodine. Here we after sublimation. Now scrape out of using a tool. I'm going to use a straw rod to scrape it off. Much of it does not because I didn't did for much time. It did sort of a failure for me. It got some sort of failure, but it still works if I did for much time.